Data volumes are rising, technology touches every part of the business, complexity rules. So how do you get a handle on it? And what's your biggest IT transformation challenge? According to recent research from Sungard Availability Services, 78% of CIOs plan to undertake a technology overhaul within the next 3 years. With applications, systems, projects and information architectures becoming more complex to manage and deliver, just where do they get started? I caught up with Keith Tilley, EVP for EMEA and Asia Pacific at Sungard AS, to find out.
Whether they're an insurance company, whether they're a retailer, it's what is IT trying to do to drive that business forward? And certainly one of the things we're finding now is that CIOs are having a bigger say and need to have a bigger say in how the business can drive benefit from the technology they're trying to deliver. So what we see is our customers coming to us and asking us for how can we help them drive that business outcome that meets the needs that are unique to their businesses. So we have a retailer who's trying to decide, how can I make sure that all my stock is delivered right on time, and if there is an interruption, how can I minimize that so that I make sure that I keep all that stock in the store that drives my business further forward. And it's amazing how technology is driving businesses to look at different ways of doing things that traditionally they haven't been able to do in the past.
Okay, sure. So this is all part of that wider movement to make IT more of a strategic function rather than a purely operational one.
Any business can derive more benefit out of IT than they possibly could have thought about in the past. I mean, insurance companies that can now drive technology to help them see how that it can change the way that premiums are set. You know, linking to satellite navigation that allows you to look at where a person's driving at what speed, so you can have a variety of insurance premiums depending on what's happening during that day. Rather than just a postcode lottery, it becomes more about the way that you drive. And that's just the way technology is what enables that to do. All the bonus cards that kind of tell us about what shoppers want and where to position things within the shop, you can't do that without technology. One of our customers, which we can name, is Sainsbury's. My local store is just doing the pay-as-you-go mobile app. I can now walk into the store, I can scan on my phone, I can walk out without having any interaction with anybody. That is great use of technology. And that kind of use exists in every organization, no matter what they're doing currently.
Do you have any recommendations for how firms get started on that journey?
So the starting point has to be, what are the business drivers that you have, and how can we use technology to help us drive towards that? And it is using outside people to be able to help that. I mean, the solutions that we provide enable companies to really look at those business outcomes, focus on the application and the content that they want, and then utilize ourselves, our services, to be able to deliver the underpinning part of that, because that is all what we do. That is our expertise, is delivering that infrastructure to be able to give you that application requirement to deliver that business outcome you want.
So how does a CIO ensure that their IT organization is robust enough to efficiently support and manage transformation as well as cope with future growth?
It's very hard these days to have experts in every area that you need when it comes to technology. So not just in the virtualization, but you've got to consider security, you've got to consider resilience, you've got to consider recoverability. And again, that's where companies like us can help, because we understand that. And also, what we're finding is, as we come out of the recession, then people are looking at their IT infrastructure, they're actually at the point where they're thinking about a refresh, and this is a good time to look at, is it time to just refresh what I've got, or is it time to take a new approach? So we're seeing quite a lot of what I would call hybrids, which is a combination of more traditional together with more of the cloud virtualized solutions. And that can be the right solution for people. Not everything needs to be virtualized, which is obviously a kind of key word at this moment in time. Everything goes into the cloud. It doesn't necessarily need to be, right? There are right things to put in the cloud. There are wrong things. But you need to have that hybrid solution to meet your needs. But you know, it is a case of picking the right time to do it, and utilizing resources that you have internally together with the expertise of other companies such as Sungard to help you drive that further forward, and also to do that in a way that doesn't disrupt what you're trying to do, right? Because the last thing you need to do is disrupt your customer service, whether that's internal customers or external customers, while you're going through that transformation.
Okay, sure. So is this about managing complexity in that sense?
It is about complexity, but as I say, it's also like breaking down that complexity. Sometimes, you know, and we see this in a variety of customers that come to us, sometimes they think they want to do everything at once. That is not always the best solution, right? Sometimes it can be. Other times it's a case of breaking it down and saying, hey, where's the priorities? What do we need to do? It's no different to our history when it's in our history in recovery. Recovery was all about which are the critical ones to recover first, and eventually everything becomes critical. In a production sense, it's exactly the same. It would be ideal to say everything needs to be 100% available. And we can do that, and we can design those solutions to be 100% available, but that has a cost with it. Does everything need to be 100% available? I'm not really sure. We have an airline company who works for us who knows that the 100% availability needs to be about booking seats and tracking their airline pilots' hours, because that's what allows them to keep flying. It doesn't mean to say the payroll system has to be 100%. It actually doesn't mean to say the cash collection needs to be 100%, because if they've got my booking, they can take the cash out of my credit card an hour later, 2 hours later, as long as they've got my booking. If they don't have my booking, then they don't have me as a customer.
Okay, so I guess to drive any transformation effort, the IT organisation needs funding. Can you share some examples of best practice approach from both camps, from IT on the one hand and from finance on the other?
If you are driving a business outcome, you can show a return on investment. You can show that by investing in this transformation, you can potentially, it could be just a cost saving initiative, but actually I think most of the transformation we're seeing is it starts off from that, but it starts to hand a degree of flexibility back to the business, say, hang on, we can do this in a flexible nature. We can burst up by using outside companies such as Sungard, such that we can cope with our peaks and demands and not have to have all that infrastructure sitting there waiting for a peak that might only happen once every 3 months. There is an onus on CIOs to talk the language of the business and not just talk, you know, speeds and gears and MIPS and fees, but talk about the business benefits in terms that the business will understand, because then it'll be far easier to get that justification. So if I could justify, hey, I need to spend this, which will improve the customer satisfaction, which therefore will improve the turnover and the profit, then that becomes a very much easier conversation than just trying to go in and say, hey, I need some money to do this because it'll make me more available. What does that mean? What's the business benefit of being available?
The emergence of the cloud and other disruptive technologies is clearly one of the key drivers behind the high number of firms looking to transform their IT infrastructures. Yet Tilley stresses that there is no right journey to the cloud, just the right journey for you. I asked him about the Sungard approach.
Cloud is an infrastructure to deliver a solution, a business outcome. Right, it's not something completely separate. So what we talk about, the right journey to the cloud, is to be able to come and talk to you about what's the business outcomes you're driving, and therefore which ones of those are best serviced by a cloud. And more importantly, you know, we offer an array of cloud solutions in order to meet the performance zones that you want. Cloud is not a solution to everything, so there could be some hybrids that have a mixture of cloud and non-cloud, private cloud and public cloud, test dev, and trying to deliver that under a single window pane to the customer so that they can see which performance zones that they need, and therefore how you promote, i.e. move, those requirements from one to the other as you need to, so you have the right solution.
Keith, you've talked about successfully delivering business outcomes. What is your key differentiator? You know, what would you say that is? Is it the blend of solutions? Is it the fact that you're not country specific? You know, where does your USP lie?
The analogy I sometimes use is that, you know, some companies, you're on a journey with IT. Some companies will treat you like a black cab, i.e. you get in the back, you say where you want to go, and they can take you whichever route they want. They might get you there, but they'll take you the route that they want. You know, I see us more as the rally car. We are the navigator by the side. You are in control, right? We will tell you that something's coming up ahead and you should turn left, and we strongly advise it. But if you decide to go straight on, here's the consequences. We will be that navigator to say, these are the best solutions that meet your business outcomes at this moment in time, and here's the reasons why. And we will leave you to focus on your true business needs as we take care of the elements that really you don't need to have under your own control. So you don't need a data center. You don't want to be buying generators. You don't want to be running this IT equipment. You want the outcome that's being driven off that.
For more fantastic interviews directly related to your business, be sure to explore Meet the Boss TV.